uncertain fate. You find yourself at an interdimensional crossroads, a rendezvous of travelers between worlds. My name is Trayden. I am an actualized post-narrative deathless wanderer and one of the tour guides of VR Travelers. We create immersive, story-based tours with original writing, beautiful worlds, voice acting, and wholesome team effort. Welcome to the rendezvous. Our point of contact to narrative domains. Tonight, I will be telling you the story of the Scavenger 2. Tonight's endings will be the neutral ending A, which has never been seen before, and the good ending. That's right, tonight we are treating you to a double ending. As such, this is going to be the last time that I perform the Scavenger 2, ever. You are welcome to stream or record tonight's event. I am going to drop an Invite Plus portal to the world of the Scavenger 2. Please, at this time, make sure that you are friends with someone else here in case you disconnect and need to send an invite request to get back into the world for any reason. Additionally, you are welcome to add myself or my fellow tour guides tonight, Rendizo and Nick, as friends, as they will be helping you to rejoin the group and keeping us flying together as a team. But enough talk. It is time to drop the portal. Please make sure that there is space in front of me, and please do not enter the portal until I give the signal that it is clear to do so. Please do not enter the portal yet, friends. Please join and wait for me on the other side.
Yippee-ki-yay! This is... yeah, this is pretty... immaculate?
Now this
water,
is what
it looks
I'm
so
talking
real.
About. Not really.
Oh, you turned it off. Wait, that's a comically large katana.
Yep.
Comically comically small person.
Look what a PlayStation I like.
Wait, it's now comically small katana.
Okay. Want a chip?
Wait, what?
You want a chip?
Oh shit, can that arrow fire? It fires. It fires. Holy shit.
No, I didn't mean to pull that out.
That's oh, it gets better.
Crazy. The, will be
fires?
First in either world.
my friends, welcome to the Tale of the Scavenger Part 2. This adventure is a continuation of the scavenger story, but if you don't know that story, fear not, for this tale can be enjoyed independently. There are only a few rules to keep in mind, so please listen carefully. Tonight's instance is clearly an Invite Plus instance. Unless you're expecting friends to join you, please make sure your status is not blue. As I am your tour guide this evening, please remain with me as best you can at all times. Please take a moment to set your world music to an immersive level. And please, when we stop for narration, kindly become silent so that the story may continue. However, as we walk from place to place, you are welcome to talk amongst yourselves. Regarding this world in particular, there is a world menu that we're going to need to use. If you are in desktop mode, press G. If you are in VR, press both triggers, both grips. Is that right, Wyatt? Two jumps for yes, I assume. Now, in this menu, you can see that it has a teleport function. You can use the teleport function to teleport to me once the tour has gotten going and you need to catch up to the group at any point. But initially, we will be teleporting, not yet, but in a moment, to the zone Arapajo Reef. Please stay here for now, though. My friends, one final note. This book beside me will toggle the post-processing brightness. Where we are going is substantially darker than where we are now, so if you find this even remotely dark, I encourage you to click the book.
Book gives you knowledge of brightness.
Lantern.
Knowledge shall enlighten you, indeed, friends. And now, if we are all ready, please use your menus to navigate to the zone Arapajo Reef, and I will see you there.
How do you get the menu to appear?
Oh, nowhere. Never thought to be 6 feet under while being alive 6 feet under. Oh, Delta, you made it.
Close.
Come on, sir.
Hey, Star.
Hmm?
I never thought to be 6 feet under
friends,
while being alive 6 feet under.
As we wait for the
under.
Other tour guides to assist those who are struggling with their menu.
Probably it's deeper than that.
Yeah, I know. It's, what is it, 1,200 feet? No, not 1,200 feet. Can't be that deep. Oh, you made it.
Oh, yeah.
I never thought to be 6 feet under while being alive 6 feet under.
Excuse me.
Hello.
You're excused.
Shut the fuck.
What? You literally came in here and burped out of nowhere.
Your attention, please.
Sorry.
Everyone has arrived. Which means, without further ado, the story begins. The scavenger is on a mission to save the people of the Oversea Realm from extinction. Where he comes from, people live in airships held above a sea of ether clouds by great creatures called titans. The scavenger had only recently learned that when a titan reaches the end of its life stage, it descends into the cloud sea to become a demigod in the subsea realms. But the descent through the ether sea kills anyone who was relying on the titan for survival. Humans cannot survive the descent through the ether sea. And yet, we join our hero as he currently descends. He, his crewman friend, and a gunner sent by the Admiral are all aboard the Ganador, a vessel of unknown origin, its hull infused with ether and not reliant on a titan for buoyancy or movement. It is, for all intents and purposes, a submarine designed for the depths of the ether sea. Their goal is to find a blue titan egg, which will act as the egg for new titans. This, in turn, shall restore balance to the Oversea Realms. They have been descending for several hours. All the while, the scavenger hears nothing but the hum of the Ganador's engines and whatever conversation occurs spontaneously between the three. It's a dull descent, but in the back of his mind, a seed of anxiety sprouts. What is it like outside? What could possibly exist down here to be a god over? Does anything even live here? Are there wreckages of sunken airships? Corpses of titans? Mountains of human bones? He shudders at the thought and tries to shake it from his mind, but the grim images persist. After a short while, the gunner says he hears something. They all stop what they're doing and listen. There is a noise. It sounds like something being plucked from the outside of the hull, again and again, and the periodic tapping of something much harder. The sound echoes through the small interior, and the scavenger becomes acutely aware of how reliant they are on the integrity of the Ganador's infused chassis. Suddenly, alarms go off. The whole vessel lurches to one side. Something pulls hard at it. All three of them are thrown to the ground. The scavenger scrambles for the oxygen tanks and masks in the cabinet as everything turns red from warning lights. There's a scream of steel, and then... silence. Blackness. Nothing. An unknown length of time passes. The scavenger slowly regains consciousness. Immediately, he notices the air. Even through his diving suit, he can feel how cold and clammy the air here is. He opens his eyes and tries to sit up. His body aches and stings, but his limbs are intact. Nothing seems broken. Wait. He's in a cave. Why is he in a cave? How did he get in here? He looks around. There's no sign of any wreckage, and the crewman and gunner are not here. But there is a person. No. No, that's not a person. It is humanoid, but the scavenger can see tentacles, arms like a squid or octopus, and it's holding a spear. What is this thing? It's standing nearby, but it isn't facing him. The scavenger feels as though he's being held captive. His mask and oxygen tank are still attached and functioning, but he's been spending air lying here for however long. He checks the gauge. Oxygen is at 85%. That's not good. He can't just sit here. He quietly gets up, wielding the robust oxygen tank as a weapon, and he sneaks up on the squidman. With all his might, he swings the steel object into the squidman's head, and it collapses in a heap, twitching, before falling still. The scavenger focuses on his goals. He needs to find that blue titan egg. He needs to find his crewman and the gunner, and he needs to locate the Ganador, all before he runs out of air. My friends, you will be prompted with choices throughout this adventure, and some choices will consume more air than others. Waste your oxygen, and the scavenger will die. But if you are too conservative, the scavenger will likely survive. But what will you achieve along the way? Let us follow the scavenger as he walks through the cave.
I recognize the cave. There's a Wendigo in here somewhere.
You know what we should call this place?
What?
Dwayne the Rock Johnson, because he's everywhere.
Shut the fuck. No.
should we call this Dwayne Cave?
No.
Yes,
Dwayne Cave.
Oh God.
Oh, the Black Mary.
Cookie.
You tried so hard right there. You tried so hard.
And got so far.
And got so far. And in the end, it didn't even matter. My friends, gather round so that the story may continue. This place.
Oh.
This place gives the scavenger a bad feeling. He looks about at all the wreckages of older style vessels, the thin layer of grey mist permeating everything, tattered sails and ropes hanging motionless. What is this place? It must be where vessels from the oversea realms settle when they sink. This must be the bottom of the ether sea. Yes, this fog, it must be ether, or something. But if that's the case, where are all the people who died? descent? Were there bodies of titans who perish? He thinks briefly of his father, who had passed away 12 years ago, and the hairs on the back of his neck prick up. Something isn't right. But the scavenger does not have time to ponder. My friends, we do not have time to ponder either, but we do have time to walk in a leisurely pace this way.
Do what you want to, because you are a
pirate. So what do you eat before you hopped on this tour? She rises early in the morning.
Morning, yep.
Okay, so it appears like we haven't eaten anything.
Go off to poop deck, yell man.
No.
Good. It needs to be swapped clean.
I'll use your famous clean. It's full of death.
And
yes,
fishes.
To be afraid of.
I imagine this would be a necromancer's favorite place to chill.
Lantern time.
I wanted to have booty on that ship.
Are you feeling it now, Mr. Krabs?
Oh my god. American clout. Come on.
I was sold for 62 cents.
I'll take the money.
Yeah.
Lamp is not working, man. Not... I forgot to refill it.
I like how you're just writing on star.
it's broken.
Elvin is writing on star.
It's light on my end.
He's exploiting star. I mean, employing star.
How
do I fix it?
No!
About time
sometimes
someone
we need to rest
me.
Our legs.
Wait, we go through the gates of hell.
I forgot you were here.
I'm down here.
Thought to become a meme
on the
now.
Floor.
Oh.
Oh, that's working, yeah.
We made a crossroad.
Ugh. Oh, crap. So...
Dude, just be the rock.
Just, I turn myself into a rock. Now, Grandpa.
Observe this lamp.
Please, it's making me rock hard.
My friends. This cave system is occupied. The scavenger can hear noises, a strange language, and a human voice. Coming from behind this door, which is ajar. If he was held captive by one of the squidmen, his friends could be as well. Usually, this is the point in the story where I will give you your first decision, for the crewman Organa may be behind this door somewhere, but checking will consume more oxygen and may have additional consequences. Instead of directly asking what you're going to do as a group, since we are locked onto the path for a certain ending, I'm instead going to turn this into a little game. This is what you're all going to do. Please gather together so that I can see you all at once. Cluster together more tightly, please.
Not too tightly. Oh,
that's what she said.
Mindful of those in VR, but yes, not too tightly. Now, my friends, navigate to your emoji menu.
Mm.
Are we gonna throw money at you? Because I'll be willing to throw money at you.
What the fuck
what
is
we're going to do is
that's for me.
I am going to say a word, and you are all going to, as fast as you can, throw the first emoji at me that you associate with this word. I'm going to be seeing a torrent of emojis, and I'm going to call out the emoji that I think was most accurate. Whoever threw those emojis will be taken to the side, and they will get to say the decision. Do you understand?
Yes.
Yes.
Yep.
Very well. Get ready, friends. Your first word is rhinoceros.
Unicorn. Dance for me, please.
Cease the emojis, my friends.
Dance.
I have seen many images. Only one stood out to me. Who threw the go emoji?
Who threw the
go emoji? Someone in this vicinity. Somebody used go.
Uh-oh.
Delta?
They me, I used a skull.
Tech nerd,
it was two of us.
Best. Everyone else, you failed miserably. Tech nerd, come here, please.
No! No, not again!
Wow, we did! Wow,
we're failures now!
You now have the very important role. My friends, your attention, please. Tech nerd, you have the very important role of having no willpower of your own and repeating after me. The scavenger is going to keep moving.
Scavenger is going to keep moving.
Wise words, tech nerd. That's exactly what we're going to do, my friends. The scavenger is not going to check this cave. He is going to keep moving. Thank you, tech nerd, for your wisdom. My friends, please follow me.
Well, I guess I'll just go.
Wait, why do I have a feeling that this is like a like the Titan sub? All you gotta do is just take off the mask, see if the air is breathable. If you start choking, put the mask back on.
I left my pills back home. Shit.
Ramps, no.
I feel how
oh shit, you got a portal gun.
I don't know. Is there a window go around here?
No.
Oh, we got another fork in the road.
Not
I love any forks.
Where's the fork? Forks in
we got.
Where are we?
We got a
where
double fork.
Who are you?
My friends. How
do I get this working?
The scavenger comes to another intersection, and through another door, he can hear more noises, more squidmen. There is another choice to be made here. These creatures seem prevalent in the subsea realm. The crewman or gunner might also be somewhere inside this door. But checking will consume more oxygen and may have additional consequences. As before, there is a choice to be made here. And as before, I would like you all to cluster together in front of me. Travelers, fingers on the emoji wheel. Are you ready for your word?
Finger.
Mm-hmm.
Silence, Grandpa. Your word, travelers, is Trey Jim.
Shit, I can't
Shit, where fuck, where could I?
My friend, the Amazes must terminate now. I'm disappointed I didn't see any hearts. However, I did see something else I liked. Something of very strong association.
Oh, no.
Those who threw tomatoes, come and stand by me.
Tomato. Tomato.
Very well.
Tomato.
Phyron, Elman, Alazu. You know your tragems. And so, I put to you the choice. Does the scavenger check this room? Say yes.
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 Yes, no, maybe so, but...
Yes, yes, and double yes. Very well. Fire on, Elman, Alazu. Thank you for your wisdom. You may return to the crowd.
You're welcome. I'm always...
You know what that means? Fish!
I always enjoy imparting my wisdom that gets us the bad endings.
Please follow me.
I'll follow you anyway. Where am I?
Anyone that talks to me will be paying $20 for each time you...
Where am I?
$20 for each time?
Hey, Lifo. I literally said, Kokomi, no! When someone mentioned fish.
This scavenger decides to investigate. He peeks through the door. There are a few squidmen gathered on top of the platform, distracted by something. The scavenger sneaks to some nearby barrels, waits until they aren't looking, and makes his way to the next room. This way, friends.
On my way.
On the road again.
I'm on my way. I don't know where I am, and I hope
I'm on my way to shut down.
We have he's in jail. Jam.
Let's go.
Actually,
he's in jail.
We're inside a cage, and I am outside of it. The story continues.
Jenny has a point.
The next room, at first glance, appears empty. As he creeps closer, there seems to be someone in one of the cells. The scavenger hurries over. It is his friend, the crewman, and his air supply seems to be intact. The scavenger pulls the lever to open the door, releasing his friend from the prison. The crewman looks very happy to see him, and asks what happened. The scavenger isn't sure. Something hit the Ganador, and then it must have crashed somewhere, and these squidmen found them and captured them. The crewman says he hasn't seen the gunner at all. After making sure his friend isn't badly injured, the scavenger and crewman continue on their way. They still need to find the Titan Egg, the gunner, and the Ganador. Oxygen is at 75%. My friends, please follow me. And Grandpa, I know you're senile and your brain is rapidly deteriorating, but I must remind you of the rule to not speak when narration is occurring. Please and thank you.
Don't leave me here!
Come on, get out, entering the whole entire door.
Okay. Leave him there. I should submit myself. That's something I was left behind.
Oh.
Don't say what.
Okay.
I'm trying to
wanna see a magic trick? I got abracadabra. I'm right through the wall.
This time you didn't leave me.
The wall, man.
Right.
Where am I?
Love that.
I almost sat on my armrest. That's gonna feel weird.
Wait, what?
Your arm what?
Armrest. I almost sat on that one instead of the main chair.
Oh, I thought you meant the other word.
If I was gonna say it, I would say it with pride.
I mean,
and then I broke a hip.
Blame you.
Murdered them in cold
blood. Did you say everything with pride?
Also, this world looks very different from what I remember.
Not always. Like talking about you.
Did you accidentally click the post processing? So the water's different.
I'm right here. I'm right here.
And like there's more animation.
I don't have the effects on because I didn't want to be too much.
Yeah.
It's basically a better world now.
The cloth.
My friends, your story continues.
And there's like more parts.
Upon exiting the cave, there comes a strange noise. The mist muffles and distorts it. And the scavenger looks up at the grayness. A shape soars across the sky. A ship without a titan. A Tornan ship. How did the Tornans get down here? The scavenger thinks back to when the Tornan commander had tried to steal that blue titan egg for himself. The scavenger stopped him, and the commander was arrested. So why are there Tornans down here now? And how did they even get here? Did they have the ability to descend into the Aether Sea all along? The crewman points out something on the side of the flying Tornan ship. He points out a strange opening, what looks like some sort of intake fan. Perhaps, he suggests, it has something to do with how that thing can fly down here. The Tornan ship moves away. It was probably too far to notice them, and so they keep moving. Oxygen is 70%. Please, follow me.
Hey Trajan, did you know that I know that you know that I know that you're a cube?
How did you know?
I don't know.
Like us.
Like I tell you my methods, amateur.
Chicken.
It's a chicken.
Hey, pal.
Clearly it's a triangle on skinny.
No, it's a hypotenuse. It's a hypotenuse.
Triangle.
I know. I was kidding.
And Trajan is clearly not a pyramid. He is a cube.
It's clearly a circle. Look at him.
You sure it's not?
What is that?
Wait. So that means if Trajan and Sheen are here, that means it's cube squared.
It's Santa Claus. Look.
He is a magic box
Trajan,
full
do you
of wonders.
Trajan, inside of you? I must know, Trajan, do you have cookies inside of you?
he's in the groove of the story.
My friends, please gather on the slope below me so that I can feel superior.
And we
yes, your holy one.
Mega men will assert their dominance.
Thank you for indulging me, and now the story must continue.
He paused you.
The scavenger pauses upon a gravelly slope. Movement on a nearby wreck catches his eye. There he sees a figure roaming, wandering, almost drifting in an unseen current. Humanoid and yet somehow not. This time it's not a squid man. The scavenger finds himself staring at it. Something about it captures his mind, holds it prisoner, until it moves out of sight, and the scavenger gasps and regains control of himself. Who was that? What was that? And why did it feel so familiar? The scavenger keeps moving. Oxygen is 65%. Please follow me.
There's nothing we can do now.
What?
Give me your oxygen. Your oxygen. What? Give me your oxygen. Your oxygen.
Oxygen. It's oxygen.
Give me your oxygen.
Who needs oxygen when you have Neon Genesis? I'm just kidding.
Give me your goddamn oxygen.
Who needs Neon Genesis when you can have hospital scene?
Give me oxygen or give me death.
Who needs oxygen when you have Chuck Norris?
When you can have childhood trauma.
Exactly.
Who needs childhood trauma when you can have dino nuggets?
No, give me. Who needs that when you have...
Who needs dino nuggets when you have Big Macs?
Give it to me. I'd rather have dino nuggets. So give me your oxygen.
I want chicken nuggets with sour cream now.
Hamburger, cheeseburger, White Mac, Whopper, hamburger, cheeseburger, Big Mac.
Actually, Tostinos sounds pretty good right about now.
Tostinos pizza rolls.
Wait, chicken nuggets with ranch?
I left my oxygen.
Chicken nuggets and ranch.
How can I sleep now?
Your oxygen.
Your oxygen. Give me your oxygen. Your oxygen. Give me your oxygen. Give me your oxygen.
Travelers, your attention, please. The deck of the shipwreck is quiet. The water below, motionless. Every plank creaks beneath his weight. There is something ahead, something just in front of him, in midair. Something is appearing out of nowhere. It is the same figure from before, off-colored skin shining in wet mist. Tattered clothing brushing the deck, drifting eerily, spectral, ghost-like, and it doesn't seem to notice him. Its voice comes abruptly, like a scraping gasp for air, and it speaks. It speaks of the sound of the void. It speaks of nothingness. It speaks of not wanting to die. It speaks of wanting to go back, of not wanting to be here anymore. And then it vanishes, dissolving into the very air. The scavenger finds himself tearing up. Why is he crying? Is he sad for the apparition? Or is there more to it? His oxygen is at 60%. Please follow me.
I'm gonna steal the scavenger's oxygen.
My head is stuck under the chair.
The oxygen is
that's a
my battery.
We need to steal his oxygen, John.
Trajan, let me steal your oxygen via reverse CPR.
Oh my gosh.
Geo, you take the scavenger's oxygen, he dies, you get the bad ending. Goodbye.
No, I changed my answer so I can take your oxygen. Trajan. You are not the scavenger.
Please, now that he's got the bad ending.
Next stage was a good ending. I want to see the good one.
Nothingness. You die. Goodbye.
You breathe the nothingness. You die.
So, are you implying that nothingness kills people?
I'm pretty sure.
I mean, I'm lonely.
Breathing in is
close.
Mr. Slow to the finish line.
You should.
Have you ever lived without nothing?
I almost fell down the bridge.
Did Trajan just tell me to kill myself?
Oh, you have an
explorer. There were times, I think.
That he did.
Yep.
I never do such
because
a thing.
Because I'm a VR truck.
He's lying. He's fucking lying about
it. Lovely.
Oh my god, I think Trajan wants me to. I think Trajan wants to off me. I just have this weird feeling. I'm scared now.
Like gatekeep.
If I wanted you dead, you'd be dead already.
Where the bias, where I lie.
What the fuck does that even
so
mean?
So we need to go where the Mayas are.
Your face, that's what it means.
Guys, I think you're asleep. I think he has eyes
on
me.
You, man. That's a pretty good joke.
Oh,
he knows what
he knows
all do.
My friends, your attention, please. The story must... Wait. What's that? Ahead in the sky, coming right this way from behind me. It's a Torna scout vessel. Everyone, hide behind something, quickly.
Hide under my hand. Oh, wait, I'm holding it.
Oh, no, not again. It's water. We're getting raided.
Move left or move right. It's not difficult, my friends.
Into the water.
Why does that sound wrong?
The ship draws closer. Closer. Its hum is distorted, corrupted by the mist. The sound becoming a muffled wail, and it passes overhead and turns away out of sight. They must be circling, looking for something. Were they followed down here when they descended? Or are they here for the blue titan egg as well? The scavenger checks his oxygen. All that excitement, it's down to 55% now. He must keep moving. This way, friends.
Hey, can someone replace my two arms? I kind of fell down and broke it.
They're not lethal. They're not considered weapons.
Oh gosh.
But I'm not armed.
Why do I hear a voice in my head telling me, "Be not afraid. Be not afraid."
He is unarmed.
I'm not hearing those voices, so you're probably going insane.
Closer to death than I ever thought.
Honestly, with someone called Pack Lover, I thought you would constantly hear "Waka Waka Waka Waka" in your ears.
I'm afraid of shit in my pants. I'm not ready to die. My fate is coming in.
Hey, Trajan, is there a way to actually get back my arms? I kind of broke them.
You need a hand?
How did you manage that?
How did you break them?
Just like,
well,
how do
see,
I keep managing to break
I
my
ripped
limbs
them out of their sockets?
No,
I guess we
I don't think these
broken.
Are the sockets.
Okay, then I cut them off, and I threw them into a fire. You have no
it's
arms
not
anymore,
broken.
Congratulations.
How the hell will you burn
that's
Gem?
Not what I asked.
How the hell will you burn
I
Gems?
I asked how he broke his arms.
I said I tossed them into a fire. I didn't say they were actually burning.
Yeah, but why
I mean,
would you burn something
lit,
like
he's so small.
Because I was bored.
Why
so
are you bored?
You destroy? Because...
So,
so you made someone.
Yeah. We get it. I'm going to look, man. I'm going through my villain arc right now. So just yeah.
Please make sure that villain arc does not mess with the rendezvous or.
Okay, people can realize me now.
I don't want you to.
You'd be surprised.
Cause something.
I feel like he's intending it.
The scavenger comes to a stop, pausing on the remains of a ship's deck, looking out across the still waters, observing, scouting, and he sees something.
I thought you were creating a glint one of my arms.
Of blue. Something glowing blue in the mist, and it appears to be moving. That must be the Titan egg. It has to be. And if it's moving, that means that someone or something has found it. The scavenger and crewman look to one another and continue with renewed purpose. Oxygen is at 50%. Please follow me.
Are we in Canada? Is that a CN Tower over there?
Wouldn't it be
no, I would expect a lot more snow.
Are we in Toronto? That looks like a CN Tower.
I'm an Armored Core. Because From Software is a good
fair enough.
Developer.
You know what? That makes more sense, actually. Everyone's
fine. Popcorn.
Don't worry, we're finding E.T.'s home.
This is a very weird school field trip.
No, this has been one. This
feels
is
like
one.
A normal one to me.
Hey, at least I'm wearing my explorer's hat. My traveler's hat.
Yep, you're prepared. While
yeah.
I'm armed.
She would totally
no, this is more like a TED talk.
Stand still for a second.
Oh, that's unfortunate. I'm sorry that someone burned your arms. That sounds like it would hurt. But are you
more
kind of
how the hell you're supposed to burn gems?
That's a good question. I don't know.
I don't know. And thank you for joining us on our TED Talk.
Because as you can see from my stump, I'm entirely made out of gem.
You should probably grow your arms back. That's like, that would be fucking weird. Not having arms.
Huh?
You should grow your other arm back. It's gotta be weird to not have arms.
Look, I found one arm.
Alright.
I found one arm. I need some duct tape to reconnect the other one.
Trajum.
Raining chocolate or something like that.
I have dark chocolate for you.
Oh, sweet chocolate.
Chocolate? Did somebody say chocolate?
Oh shit.
Chocolate!
Okay.
Oh shit. Oh, sweet. That voice was high pitch. Luckily, I can't break from high pitch.
The story continues.
Fuck.
Bro, calm down. You're not turning a car, aren't you?
The scavenger stops. He can hear voices on the shipwreck nearby. He listens to their accent. Tornans again. They must have landed and disembarked. But judging by the way they're talking, they do not have the blue Titan egg. In fact, they are talking about having spotted an unmanned powered vessel nearby on their radar, and of a monster lair nearby with increased activity. After a few moments, the Tornans then move away. But just as the scavenger takes a step forward, he notices something. Away from the shipwreck, down another path, something takes shape. The apparition appears once more, standing upon a distant shore, drifting back and forth on the spot, looking at the scavenger, and the scavenger cannot bring himself to look away. The feeling is profound. What is it? What is it? He knows. He knows who this is. Yes, he knows whose ghost this is. It's the ghost of his father. My friends, usually you would have an important choice to make here. But as before, I'm going to turn this decision-making process into a little game. Please gather together in front of me in one group. In case anyone has joined late, let me explain the rules of this game. I am going to say a word, and all of you, having already navigated to your emoji menu, will use the first emoji that comes to mind that you associate with the word that I say. When I see an association that pleases me the most, I'll name the emoji, and anyone who used it will come forth. You may only choose one emoji each. Now, please navigate to your emoji menus now and get ready for the emoji association game, TM. Travelers, your word is fungus. Alright, that is enough, my friends. Whoever's using the pizza emoji, for shame. Now, whoever is using the hourglass emoji and using the custom emoji of a sock, which is normally cheating, but who cares? Sock and hourglass, please come forth.
Foot fungus.
Burger King foot fungus, the one thing you don't want to find in your Burger King burger.
Now, this is yes, Captain Panda and Angelic Angel. You both used the sock and hourglass, is that correct?
Yep.
I used the hourglass, yeah.
I used very the well. Salts. Disgusting. I love it. Now, my friends, you get the privilege of guiding the group on their next action. But I'm using you as a simple vessel, devoid of your own free will and mental faculty. Repeat after me. The scavenger is not going to pursue the ghost of his father.
The scavenger is not going to pursue the ghost of his father. The scavenger is not going to pursue the
ghost of his father. My friends, we are not a cult. Please follow me.
Wait, are we a cult now?
No, I'm pretty sure we've always been a cult.
You use it on
just now, finally accepting
the cult of what?
Also, if anyone's the leader, it's definitely Trajan because he's like, he's the one. Sheen is the face, but Trajan is the brains.
Don't you guys also do you guys remember last time when we discovered when we talked about Trajan's Trajan's insane cloning operation?
Remember when you were shocked about
he's
it?
He's been cloning Vin Diesel for years.
Oh yeah, I remember that. Vin Diesel's on the 27th.
We're on like the 31st Vin Diesel by now, I think.
So that explains Vin Diesel constantly crashing in the pilot.
Yeah, when Vin Diesel constantly crashes, that clone of Vin Diesel dies and is replaced by another one.
Mine!
I guess the clone machine was having
a
field day at that moment.
Not blown.
There were some bugs that were being worked out.
I mean, during the crashing spree, yeah.
I mean, we're in VR chat.
He was being cloned over and over again. I don't know what to tell you.
What is my purpose? To join
so, Vin Diesel Clone Wars. The Vin Diesel Clone Wars.
Your purpose is to accompany people on tours in a virtual game known as VR chat.
I'm literally riding on Star.
What is my purpose? You pass butter.
It's starting to become a meme.
Oh my god.
Yes.
Yeah, right, yes, Raw? Did. Yeah.
The scavenger that cannot give up. His father's ghost could have been a monster. It could have lost all its humanity. It could be an illusion. No. Cannot be distracted now. Too many people are depending on him. He makes his way to an old bridge, and he and the crewman pause. He hears something. He looks up. Crossing the wooden bridge are three squidmen, and they have someone with them. A person. It could be the gunner, but the scavenger can't get a good look without risking being seen. They wait for them to pass, and then keep moving. Oxygen is at 40%. Oxygen is
at 40%.
Thanks, Gio.
Are you choking?
No, I'm just sucking up that luscious oxygen.
That sounds like you're sucking something else off.
Don't put it in context like that.
You want to test that theory?
Sucking the oxygen.
Let me just
wrap my mouth around that big fat oxygen.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, sweet.
As oxygen decreases, ours increases.
This is a bowl of nothing. But you see, it's actually a bowl filled with oxygen.
I'm tired, okay.
I call it chaotic.
Who wants some oxygen hot dogs?
Guys, we have to convince Sheen to put oxygen soup at the bar.
I'm on Panda.
My favorite.
Yeah,
oxygen.
My eyes are literally trying to adjust.
Next floor, I'm ordering that.
Panda.
Okay.
I'm literally just adjusting to this.
Not if
you're gonna
I order
have to go lower.
Okay,
right. You don't mind, right?
Oxygen. Hold on, give me a second.
No. Just
you
ordered
already.
Just order liquid oxygen.
See, like, the joke with reverse alcohol is that reverse alcohol is actually supposed to be just water.
Just order liquid oxygen.
What about reverse oxygen?
It's not.
That's oxygen.
It's just oxygen soup. I don't fucking know what Sheen's gonna do with oxygen. You know what? Maybe instead of cursing you, it blesses you or something. Ooh. I don't fucking know. We'll find out.
I'll be right back.
Anyway, would you like some oxygen soup?
I would love some oxygen soup. Do you want some oxygen soup?
Is that oxygen frozen?
I would love some
frozen oxygen
soup.
Okay, here. Give me a second. There you go.
No, if it's oxygen soup, that thing
right,
is liquefied,
just put
which
some
is freezing.
In the soup. Just breathe into it.
Oxygen soup. Okay.
Just breathe into
no,
the
soon.
There's some oxygen soup.
Just in the gas at room temperature. You have
nice
to
inhale.
Kind of push like.
Exhale.
Thank you.
Your attention, please.
Like
the story must continue.
No, thank you.
I made this for you. I made this for you.
The story must continue, my friends. Your attention, please. The scavenger and crewman stop near the bridge. He looks over in time to see a group of squidmen on the other side, coming this way. They dive down behind a boulder nearby to hide, but they're getting closer. Now they're trapped behind a boulder. If they move, they'll be seen. The crewman has an idea. He tells the scavenger to stay put while he distracts them. Before the scavenger can object, the crewman jumps out from behind the rocks and runs, sliding down the rocky slope of the plateau. The squidmen cry out, and one throws a spear. It misses. They all jump down and give chase, and the scavenger cannot see his friend anymore from up here. He waits a moment, but no, he cannot linger. Now is his chance to move. He gets up and crosses the bridge before he's noticed. Oxygen is 35%. This way, friends.
If only we could suck the oxygen off of these squidmen.
What?
Yeah, we're gonna take their oxygen soup.
Yeah, we are siphoning their oxygen to make some.
I don't have anything to hide.
I can't believe
my back is hard.
Remember, guys, oxygen soup is best consumed with reverse alcohol.
Trajan is infallible.
Maybe Trajan doesn't need oxygen at all.
No, but like, he could still enjoy oxygen soup.
Oxygen?
Sure.
Well, yeah, exactly. That's why they call him Oxygen. That's an
oxygen.
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 He's Oxy.
Oxygen.
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 Call yourself Oxygen.
Billy Bass here with some Oxy Slim.
Please do this. Please.
Please never listen to you ever.
Shut your damn mouth, Pack. Do you know what's good for you?
Please.
What's good for you is falling silent so that the story may continue.
Okay. Yes, father. I mean, what?
The scavenger stops and puts his back to a pillar, for he can hear squidmen down this long cavern. But there is a door right there which, judging by the light, seems to be an exit. He has another chance to check for squidmen prisons, or to leave this cave and avoid wasting oxygen. my friends, you know the drill. It's time to make a decision. It's time for emoji association. Please, gather together in front of me and open your emoji menus. Now, travelers, your word is
loading
coal.
God damn it, sick drift.
He's showing very balls. Well, cease the emojis. Now, to those who didn't use coal, very creative, but this was a trick question. I was just looking for coal. Those who threw coal, please step over here.
That guy, but he said coal. And coal.
You see?
Very well. Now, five brain geniuses. What do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You're all very clever and very unoriginal. Well done.
Thank you, I guess.
For no
Sonic Avengers!
I still can't believe you think that fungus is not mushroom for that.
Travelers. Since you have all signed the contract to give your self-control over to me for the duration of this tour, this is the choice that you're all going to make for the scavenger. He is going to spend the oxygen required to check one of the prisons. Do you all agree? Say yes.
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 Yes. Yes. Yes. My dubs. Are in the air.
And now, to register this answer with the encephalon, please repeat after me. We love Trajim.
We love Trajim!
We love
Trajim!
Jinx is better.
I bet you're all jealous now. My friends, please come with me.
I bet you're all jealous now.
Jinx, what did you do to him?
I mean, I could have put in fire. I was pretty close because Cole gets lit. My soul.
Killed freedom and took his soul. Oh no.
He gave me a head!
Let's go.
Who said that?
Well, I didn't drop this one, so.
Where are you having a step up?
A robot chicken joke.
Those two really want to go in prison.
My friends, your attention, please. I need to ask you all something. Who has memories where, as a child, they were with their parents or caregivers somewhere, and the adults were doing adult things, and you were told to entertain yourselves, and so you found the nearest thing nearby that had verticality to it, a playground, some steps, whatever it was, and you clambered over it to your heart's desire for as long as you wished. Who has such memories?
Wait, what?
I do.
Yeah.
I had a
Game Boy.
For those who don't have these memories, you're about to make them. Please spend the next 2 minutes climbing over all this equipment while I take a short break. See you soon.
Yay! Yeah!
Oh shit, his arms! He lost his arms!
Come on!
I have to hand it to you for that joke.
Hey,
wee. Cilantro, I dare you to make it here. Right on this spot that I'm standing.
Hey, some kid nearly lost an eye. Those were the days.
Can you help me put a rope around my neck?
I
found it.
I do used to climb the fireplace.
I was trying to make it to the other one.
So you do the ancient art.
Jump. I don't even know where this come from.
Wait, wait. What? What did you say?
I got a...
Hey, that's mine.
You got rope.
Can you hang me with this?
Wait, what?
Oh. Parker, parker! Wait, wait, wait!
Ow!
Get back!
I'm too bad to
go. I'm arms.
Shit.
Does anyone have
right,
a heal?
Passing by the
biblically
accurate angle.
Don't worry, I can give you.
I feel young again.
But you need a hand, right?
Get the pun! Now heal me!
Be not afraid.
I landed the vault.
You know,
Adrenaline. I have adrenaline.
Shoot.
That's okay.
Not gonna heal me.
Give it to me.
I gave you adrenaline right to the head. Hopefully, it doesn't do any long term damage.
You do realize I'm
well, it's from
Lumberton,
right? Too, right?
To
so, they'll be
a
fine.
Specific spot.
No,
you're
they won't.
Armor.
They would be retarded
your
for this.
Should have broke.
Wake up.
Michael, wake up. Wake up. Wait, that's a- wait, what?
What are you doing here?
What? What?
That's a long break.
That is insane!
Wanna climb?
What? Wait, I-
Rick Chim.
What's insane?
No!
Where am I? Yeah,
it's a pole!
Am I gonna die soon?
It's a fishing stick.
Pole.
It's like a fishing rod.
With the amount of metal being flared to you,
they're gonna jump off.
Oh, he's riding his rod. I get it now.
Nah.
Yeah,
it's
I'm on the rod.
It's a bit shaky.
Whoa.
It is, yeah.
Where am I?
Wow.
Whoa.
There's a big rod.
Jump. There you go.
You may need.
Thank you.
Anyone else on the ride?
We're up here
shake
now.
Vigorously. Shake him vigorously.
Asshole.
Ah! I'm freaking...
I didn't know you were looking up
hey,
there.
Hey, asshole.
Elven is a high.
And
oh,
travelers, your attention,
oh,
please.
God.
Your playtime has come to an end.
Your playtime.
I think this is more than just playtime, say Jim. I'm so sorry that you have a chaotic environment.
Interesting. My friends, please return to me. The story
okay.
must continue. My friends, please return
yes,
to me. The story must continue. I see some people up there on the platform. Here they come.
I
gather around, friends.
I hijack the crane controls.
Humanity.
I don't know, Dildo. I don't even know where it came from.
And now, the story continues. The scavenger investigates the grimy cave. He's come this far already. He may as well look. He watches his footing, checking around corners. To make sure he doesn't bump into any squidmen. He chooses the first left and scans the dark cavern. He can see him. The gunner is lying there on the ground, bound and left near the stairs. There are squidmen here, but they are arguing about something. They're distracted, but if he got too close, he would be noticed. And then, he has an idea. He follows the cave wall, climbs up the side of the stairs to the top of the platform, and fumbles with the ropes of the primitive crane until whatever it's carrying comes crashing down on top of the squidman. The scavenger hurries back to the gunner. He's conscious and moving, and his oxygen tank is operational. He even still has his weapon on him, but he couldn't reach it with his wrists bound. They must have found him unconscious, but don't seem to be intelligent enough to deprive them of their oxygen or their weapons. The pair quickly flee from the cave, but it seems the crash alerted some nearby squidmen, and so they are forced to head for the exit with 30% oxygen. However, near the exit, they bump into someone. The crewman skids around a corner, safe and sound, and says he thoroughly lost the squidmen. The squidmen are scary and armed, but they cannot run very fast, he says. The three of them are reunited, and together they exit the lair. Please follow me.
Okay, that was funny. What happened to L-Man?
What happened to him?
He was on the pole. He was shoved up and down.
Oh yeah.
I hijacked the crane controls.
The stick was up his asshole, man.
I'm sorry.
It was right up in there.
I mean, he had some intense action there for about 5 minutes.
Been doing this so long, you forgot what it feels like.
I have not. If I walk into these things.
And here, on the right, we have an old guy that's just laying down.
Meh.
Right behind us, we have chaotic people.
We have some wholesome...
There ain't nothing more.
We have rocks.
Here.
Rocks and more rocks.
We have Dwayne the Rock Johnson. He's everywhere.
This is not the Dwayne cave.
You there, you owe me some money, or Goku.
The scavenger, crewman, and gunner exit and begin another trek across the open grayness of the outdoors. Despite the dreary landscape, sullen weather, he's glad to be out of those dark, slippery caves where a squidman could be lurking around any corner. They reassess their goals. They still need to find the blue titan egg and the Ganador. Oxygen is at 25%. Surely they can still make it, can't they? Let's find out. This way, friends.
L-Man has become the Goomba.
Goomba, fuck you!
The groomer.
This creme brulee is really good.
Elman turned himself into a diglet!
What's...
He's diglet Elman!
You ever feel so bad for a while?
The other kid, Winter's Trio.
Wait, if we're mentioning about Squidman, does that mean that we're talking about Squidward? Squidward?
I can't do the Squidward voice, goddamn. That was terrible.
Everyone's an idiot except for me.
Everyone's an idiot except for me.
The trio see movement in the distance, and they crouch down. The scavenger sees a small group of Tornans heading into a nearby cave. It must be the group he overheard from earlier, which means they're probably on the way to investigate that unmanned vessel they picked up on their radar that the scavenger overheard them talking about earlier. That could be the Ganador. That could be their only chance to get back to the surface in one piece before the Tornans find the vehicle and do something to it. But when he looks down the other path, he sees more movement. And he catches a glimpse of something shining blue. It must be the Titan Egg. My friends, you know what this means. Another choice to be made. Another round of emoji association, TM. Please cluster together in a group down below in front of me and get your triggers ready on the emojis. The association word is Constantinople.
Constantinople.
Alright, that's enough emojis. Honestly, quite rubbish, but I saw a couple that I liked. Who used the ghost emojis? Please come forth.
It's Istanbul, not Constantinople.
Was that just one of the lazuli rhyme?
I know I did. I don't know if anybody else did.
Come and stand up here on the hill of you're better than everyone else. Ah, Lifeform, did you use the ghost emoji?
Tell you the truth, I used it earlier, but not for this one.
Go downhill.
I don't know, I used the keyboard.
I used the beach ball.
Down here,
Lifeform.
Come on.
Go home. This is only for Lazuli Rhyme. I appreciate that you got the reference, at least, I hope you did. Now, we have a choice here to make. The choice between following the Tornans and securing what seems to be the Ganador, or pursuing what would appear to be the Blue Titan Egg. Now, I'm going to leave this choice down to you. No, I'm not. Repeat after me. The scavenger.
Repeat after me. Scavenger.
The scavenger.
Is going.
is going.
Wait, I need to check my notes.
Get angry. Run.
That was just a test.
Sure, buddy.
All right. You didn't repeat what I said.
I'm gonna be real with you. Lag is really bad today. I didn't hear what you said.
I don't remember saying that either. Oh well, let's go on with it. Now, the scavenger is going to.
The scavenger is going to.
Shut the fuck up, old man.
Repeating
once
what you
I
said.
Agree with Pack, the scavenger is going to pursue the blue light.
The scavenger is going to pursue the blue light.
A genius idea. My friends, instead of going for neutral ending A and then to the good ending, I'm taking you to the good ending first and then to the never-before-seen neutral ending A. Because this way, it is more narratively satisfying. This way.
Do you think I have enough brain power
for choices?
You are horribly mistaken.
Hooray for Demon Core!
I think that means we need to plug him anyway.
I'm not gonna lie, I was really confused. I don't know what the fuck's going on. I thought he said repeat myself, or repeat after me, so I'm just repeating whatever he said.
Who knows?
But he
said specifically for
Lazuli Rhyme to do that, not you.
Shit, I thought he meant all of us. Shit.
Don't mind me, I'm just getting.
I mean, none of us literally spoke. That's the thing.
Repeat after me.
Yeah, I thought that was a part of the joke. Shit. So I meant like hope two groups.
The thing is, God, I think you're the punchline.
Why are they punching me?
All right, I'm winding up my freaking fist for this line.
Don't do it. Oh, please. I'll do anything.
Anything?
Don't
yes,
you fucking
anything.
Hey, yo, you should never say that. You would walk into something that you would not expect.
Well then, go swap the poop deck.
Oh, eat the poop deck. I mean, swap. Yeah.
Wait, did you
whatever
just
you
say
said.
Eat the poop deck? What is this? Man, that's pretty.
What the?
The scavenger, crewman, and gunner all head to where they had seen the blue light. They're sure it was the deck of this ship. They walk across it slowly. Looking around here, it was just here, somewhere.
Shit.
Yes. He can feel it. That same emanating energy from when he first encountered it. It's definitely nearby. It's so close. It's a trap. Squidmen jump up into view, threatening the scavenger with spears, and one of them holds up the blue titan egg, taunting. This is life or death. My friends, in this combat, you have but one choice to make. With oxygen at only 15%, factor in.
We steal their oxygen.
That fact with your choice. Your options are...
Does it?
Run. Attack the squidman holding the egg, or attack one of the other squidmen. For those who wish to run, stand back on the stairs this way. For those who wish to attack the squidman holding the egg, stand over here. For those who wish to attack one of the other squidmen, stand over here. Please
don't worry,
make your
I got
choice
this
now.
Don't worry, Goku, I got this. I'm armed.
Didn't know you had a child. Congratulations, brother. Which side is it gonna defend?
Wait, does anyone have a lighter? All they need is
I
a
do
lighter.
Is it in my pockets?
This is the runaway option.
Thing is, my hands are glued.
And my please pockets hold still while I count the votes.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. What was this option again?
Attack the egg.
Attack
the
titan. Attack
the
egg.
Bearer.
What are you asking me?
Very well. Travelers, return to me so that the story
may continue.
You're a
very nice, biblically accurate angel.
Thank you.
What?
Am I gonna
be
die?
Be not noisy and listen well.
Yes.
The scavenger decides to go for the squidman holding the blue titan egg. He only has time to give the gunner and crewman a nod of preparedness, and the three of them jump into the fray. A javelin comes straight at the crewman, but he rolls under it, managing to tap the squidman's legs as he falls. The gunner gets off a shot at the other squidman before he can throw his javelin, and the scavenger launches himself at the one holding the titan egg. That blue glow becomes more fierce, more intense as he draws nearer and nearer. The energy tingles, and the scavenger throws himself at the monster, reaching for the egg at the same time. It fights back ferociously, tentacles flailing as it lets. He turns its crystalline form over, appreciating its beauty. His fingers palm forward. Find Ganador. Can they even escape at this point? My friends, we have only 10% oxygen left. Please listen carefully to the following. I need all of you to open this world's menu again, the teleport menu. Navigate to the zone called Cutter Cove at the bottom. I would like to meet you all there at Cutter Cove. Please teleport there now.
I do all your green. I love my least green ground at home.
How do I get the thingy? How the heck do I get
press
the grape thingy?
Teleport type of the grip. Uh-huh.
Voice. Ripping the gripper.
Oh. What? Where did he say to go to?
Cutter Cove.
Double tap the grip.
One.
Double squeeze your controller.
Oh, Cutter Cove. What are you looking at?
feel it. I'm scared.
There you go.
Couple of minutes, friends, as we try to get everyone into this new section of the map.
I literally just deja vu.
Well, looks like we got most. Looks like we finished the battle with no harm to my.
Please come with me.
Dang it!
Why? It's funny.
Not even that funny. What are you doing laughing?
I'm sorry. I just love puns.
Dang.
Puns? I thought that was a pity laugh.
It wasn't a pity laugh. I just laugh at the stupid shit.
Where do fish sleep? The seabed.
Look, Gordon, a boat! We can use these to go over water!
That's not a water. Who the fuck? What is that thing?
Oh shit, it's the Mayflower!
My face? I was wondering
where the scavenger exits the cave and comes to a different section of water. And in the distance, he sees a vessel docked. That is not the Ganador, but it does appear to be viable transport. The scavenger begins to face the possibility that the Ganador is gone, and that this might be his only chance to return home to the Oversea realm. Then he notices something else. He expected to see Tornin's standing guard on this vessel, and he does see Tornin. But they are dead. They are all dead, scattered around the place, motionless, wounded, as though there was some sort of shootout here. And it looks recent, too. What happened? The scavenger didn't hear any weapons being fired. He asks the crewman and gunner, they didn't hear anything either. Who else has guns? No, this doesn't make any sense. It doesn't make any sense at all. He looks down the blue titan egg, as though it's going to reveal to him the answer. He looks at it, for a reason he cannot explain. Something about this seems convenient. He approaches the ship.
Who's sending an airstrike? Oh fuck, it's over there. Oh, that scared me a little. Holy shit. Oh, the thing has a mind of his own. So scary. What did the wave say to another wave? Nothing. They just waved.
Watch your step.
Literally, watch your step.
Watch your step. It's like goes everywhere.
I wasn't sure about that joke either.
No, help me. What? Huh?
The gunner goes first. Weapon at the ready to confirm that there are no Tornans hiding on the ship. He goes in. A minute passes. 2 minutes pass. And then someone emerges. The gunner, once more, looking confused. He says it's empty. Everything is clear. He is just as perplexed as the other two. But it would appear that they now have access to an operational vessel which can ascend back to the oversea realms. My friends, against all odds, you have made it. Please allow me to congratulate you on your accomplishments. You have reached the good ending of the Scavenger 2. Well done.
Yippee-ki-yay!
Yay! Yay! We did nothing to make it here!
Yay! Huzzah! Yay,
we did absolutely nothing, yeah. But yet we got here. Let's go!
And we only got right.
It was all my friends, your attention,
well,
please.
And missing
this
ones.
Event is not over. This is one of two endings that we have prepared for you tonight. I have mentioned from the start that neutral ending A has never been seen before. That means that until the moment you are all about to witness, nobody has made full sense of what happens during this adventure. The point we need to rewind to go down this path, is nearby. It was the point where we last decided to investigate the blue light instead of following the Tornans. If instead we followed the Tornans, we would have seen something much different. Let's do that now. My friends, please follow me.
Finding like a VHS tape.
Following the leader, the leader, the leader. Following
oh,
the leader, wherever they go.
And you thought so.
To be specific, if I can check from here, Final Fantasy 11.
Don't worry, the good ending only costs you both arms.
Don't jinx it. I could lose more than just an arms.
My friends, this is what has happened. The scavenger, crewman, and gunner did not investigate the blue light. Instead, they saw it more important to secure the vessel, and so they followed the Tornans directly into the cave. Why did I have us walk back in here just to walk out again? For the exercise, of course. My friends, please follow me.
That chair when I needed.
This time I didn't actually fall asleep and let others leave me behind.
Yes, Star. It would have been like abandoned.
Abandon the ship.
The scavenger, crewman, and gunner exit the cave and come to a different section of water, and in the distance the scavenger can see a vessel docked. It is not the Ganador, but it is viable transport. The scavenger begins to face the possibility that the Ganador is gone, and that this might be his only chance to return home to the Oversea realm. The scavenger is yanked behind a rock suddenly. The gunner pulled him in, and he points out Tornin's standing nearby that the scavenger did not notice. We can hijack the ship, the gunner says. I can see only two of them have guns on them. If we ambush them, we can easily take this ship from them and use it to get home. The scavenger isn't sure. He only has 15% oxygen, and it's about to drop again. They do not have the blue titan egg, but they have learned a lot. And coming back with this strange vessel of this size will be useful. He agrees, and they prepare their ambush, going over the details for just a minute. And then, like clockwork, they activate their plan. The gunner opens fire at the nearest armed Tornin, ambushing him. Those standing near the victim look around in shock, but the scavenger is already going for the fallen weapon. Between him and the gunner, they subdue the remaining Tornins. A swift victory. Cautiously, the three of them approach the docked vessel and look over it. It seems functional. And so, realizing that now this is their only chance to leave, they take the opportunity. My friends, the scavenger is out of time. He has not succeeded in his quest to retrieve the blue titan egg, but he is returning to the Oversea realm alive, with his friends and with 10% oxygen. All the while, not realizing that they are being observed the whole time. My friends, welcome to neutral ending A of the Scavenger 2, and the last ending for the Scavenger ever.
Oh!
Yeah, no, I
what do I... Why do I feel like that there would be more eventually?
I mean, there would be
continued.
More. To be continued.
My friends,
to be contended.
Your attention, please. In just a moment, we'll be taking a group photo. But first, I'm sure you're wondering. Was the fight we just had, did that outcome roll into a different storytelling? How did one ending change the other ending? Well, the key, I will tell you, is in where we are. This is not the subsea realms, but somewhere else. My friends, we are VR Travellers. We create immersive, story-based tours with original writing, beautiful worlds, and wholesome team effort. We do this for fun, and we do this for free. However, we do ask one thing in return. Please join our Discord community and post photos and comments from today's tour in the Scavenger 2 channel. There you can discuss alternate endings, the mysteries of the lore, the secrets of the headquarters, and more. The ID for the Discord server is in my status in VR chat. If you need help joining the Discord, please come and see me after the tour. Finally, if you really enjoy our work, and you want to help us write more stories and create more worlds, then please consider supporting us on Patreon. Our Patreon starts at $3 a month, and joining gives you access to clues to mysteries, behind-the-scenes features, eligibility to play NPC roles in some tours, a private Discord channel, and more. The link to the Patreon is in our info channel on the Discord. Subscribing for a year is still less than you would pay for a AAA game. And now, my friends, soon, in a couple of minutes, I am going to drop a portal to the after party where you are all welcome to come back with us to the rendezvous. There we will spend time together as friends and companions, and we will... I will be at the bar tonight, as Sheen is not here. Elman will assist me at the bar, which means I'm not doing loans tonight. My apologies. But before we go to the after party, let us take a group photo. My friends, I suggest we take the group photo on this mysterious vessel down here. What do you say?
Yeah.
Elman can be in the water. Everyone else to follow me.
Elman can be in the water. Elman, come on. We don't need to.
He's gonna rust.
Oh, I totally.
Elman water.
I totally heard that wrong.
Elman waters.
Never mind. Never mind.
What? You wanted to waterboard Elman? I would.
No, I thought they saw all man go into water, and I was like, wait, what?
Everyone get in the water.
Man.
Up here, my friends, facing the rest of the ship. Photographers, please arrange your cameras now.
Okay. Give me a second while I get my camera ready.
There it is!
This time I know how to make my own photos.
I see Goku God
yes.
And Bot Kilman. There we go.
I appear to have fallen.
Everybody smile.
I still, okay.
I don't have smile, so I cannot.
Just smile
very
and
well.
Wave,
carve
boy.
My friends. On the count of three, what are we saying to farewell this narrative?
Soup.
No.
Oxygen soup.
Oxygen soup. The most prevalent substance on this planet.
Oxygen.
Very well, my friends. On the count of
oxygen
three,
soup.
We are all saying, oxygen soup. Photographers, are you ready? That's a yes. One, two, three.
Oxygen.
But if you have other things to do tonight, then that is completely fine. I'll just add your name to a miscellaneous list. Your floor is yours until I drop the portal.
Robert,
is it a magical portal?
You're killing one.
I was